This competition is brought to you by Qantas. Qantas is celebrating small business with an amazing opportunity. Every week, one business could win $1,000 worth of Qantas flights to use for business travel. How do you enter? Easy. Go to qantas.com/SME and tell us in 25 words or less how Qantas can help manage your business travel. Pearson's Florist has been successfully building their online business for several years. Third-generation family member Avi Pollack wants to upgrade the site, so I've sent him to meet John Lonergan, head of Qantas.com, to get some tips from the big end of town.
It struck me when I did a bit of research to have a look at ordering flowers that there's a plethora of different ways I can do this online. How would you see Pearson's differentiating itself inside that pool?
I guess Pearson's traditionally has differentiated ourselves by being a premium product, by providing excellent customer service. We've always bent over backwards to make sure our customers are happy, to make sure that their needs and wants are met. And moving online, we're looking to replicate that.
It strikes me that's a good market niche to go into. It's not dissimilar to Qantas. I think one of the challenges most businesses face when they move online is how do you balance off the need for the customer to feel that I have access to all the products available and so I don't need to go anywhere else, with just the absolute confusion of having so many options presented. And you have to do that in two ways, I think. You have to streamline the back and get your products quite simple. And then you have to go through your order process and make sure you're showing enough information to the customer at each step in the process so they're not overloading them with decisions or overloading them with complex things. Just to give you an example, you know, I think Qantas has 40 flights a day between Sydney and Melbourne. So anytime someone wants to go to Melbourne in the morning, back in the afternoon, there's 80 flights to choose from, 5 different fare types on each flight, and then 14 days at a time we show people the price points. So if you look at that, there's 2 million combinations in that. And yet we know by the time customers come to that page, most people can choose their options from that page in less than a couple of minutes. So it's amazing what people can actually process if you've gone to the trouble of making the options simple.
With the website redevelopment that we're looking at, and specifically the navigation side of it, what are some of the do's and don'ts that we should be looking at?
I think one of the important things to remember is that no matter how good your website is, your customers spend more time on other sites than they ever will on yours. So navigation is not an area where you want to be out there and state your claim at being unique, because you really want them focusing on the points of difference that you actually have around you, the quality of your product, not on how do I actually get around this site. Yeah. When we do changes to Qantas.com, we base it on customer feedback. So we get emails back from customers asking us how things work or how could they do things. We base it on analytics. We track all the movement around the site, and we look at that quite strongly. With fast internet speeds now, people expect a certain level of service, and they expect to be able to do things in a certain amount of time. They don't need to spend time learning how your site works. A lot of the traps that people get into is they take their offline copy and their marketing material, and they just cut and paste and put it online. Again, you know, you need to do that, and then you need to halve it. And then when you think you've halved it, you halve it again. Because people don't spend the time reading, they don't have the same ability. So all those things go to making a great website.
This technology building block is brought to you by Telstra Business.
Not every business requires the same communication tools. In fact, the best solutions are often custom made by someone that understands how your company works. There's more than 60 Telstra business centres all around the country, and their main purpose is to figure out exactly what your business needs. Certified professionals are available to take you through the latest technology solutions and Telstra offers. And in order to tailor the best possible solution for your company, they'll even come out to visit you and see how your business works day to day. Of course, sometimes it's easier to understand technology if you can actually see it working. So it's a good idea to visit your local centre for a demo. It's also comforting to know that each Telstra business centre is a small business themselves, so they really do understand your local community and the challenges of growing a small business.
To find out how a Telstra Business Centre can support your small business, visit telstra.com to find your local centre. After the break, tips on family succession and business planning.
Sometimes I see business plans that are this thick and they don't necessarily need to be.